So we recently held a conference here in Sydney, and I taught a quarterstaff workshop, and it was asked, how the hell do you bout with these things without killing each other? And so this is a video showing exactly how you do it and what you need to be able to do it.
So a real quarterstaff is obviously unusable, okay? It's an enormous, heavy 8-foot lump of ash or oak. The real ones were shod with iron, which means they had something like that on each end. But even if it's blunt, okay, you simply can't bout with these hardwood staves. It's not just the fact that the weight of them makes them unsafe. It's the fact that there's no flex at all. So when you start hitting people on the head with something like this, the weapon itself transfers all the force into them. They're really unforgiving and very, very dangerous to fight with. And being so long, they generate an enormous amount of force on some of the big circular swings. So what are your options if you want to fight? Well, over the years, we've tried all sorts of things. So I'll start off by telling you some things that don't work. So first of all, bamboo, okay? So bamboo is very, very, very light. It also just breaks, okay? These are not really any good for fighting. You just chew through them far too quickly, as well as them being unrealistically light. PVC pipe tends not to break, is fairly flexible, is again very, very light. The big problem with this is it just doesn't feel like wood in any way, shape or form. They just slip and slide all over each other and just don't feel very satisfactory. So we did try these as a substitute for once and wasn't impressed. A sport that has a similar kind of weapon to a quarterstaff is naginata, when they make these things called shayai, which are a nice, slightly oval wooden shaft with a bamboo naginata head on the end there. And I have a pair of these and I use them as a very light introductory sparring weapon. The main issue with them is they're a little bit short, they're only 7 foot tall, and again, they're really super, super light, so people swing them around doing things that you really can't do with a wooden staff. They aren't bad, they're the best of the options I've shown you so far, but we can do better. So this is an SCA pole arm grade rattan pole, and this has got a significant amount of weight to it. It's got the heft that makes it feel like a real weapon, but it also has a little bit of flex. So how much? Just enough. So you can see, if I just brace it and give it a pull, I can bend it like that, which means as you hit people on the head, it does absorb a reasonable amount of the force. So this is basically what we've been using to spar for, you know, probably over a decade now. And overall, they aren't too bad. You can see there's just a little bit of a wobble, but it's actually pretty good. So if you're serious about quarterstaff, particularly sort of the early silver-esque sweatnamy type staff, a weapon that is big and heavy enough to, as Wild puts it, laugh and bid defiance at any other weapon, and if you want to cross bout with people with swords and things and show them just how much better one of these is, then a big heavy rattan staff is probably the way to go. Okay, so that is a definite option. But you do have to armor up for these, okay? You guys have already seen sort of the level of protection that I tend to wear. I did get a overhand thrust single in the face with one of these once at a demonstration bout. If you look at our Winterfest videos, you'll probably find it, where I was thrust in the head coming forwards and had my steel-faced helmet shoved straight back into my face, and I was fine, okay? But had that been a fencing mask, it may have been a different story. So you do need to armor up with these things, because they're still a big, heavy weapon, and there's still a certain amount of potential danger in there if you're wielding them with gusto. So as the final option, and this is the one that I'm going to recommend you start with until you build yourself up to that, is a much thinner rattan staff. So this is the sort of thing that they used in the 19th century for sporting type quarterstaff. Okay? It's much, much lighter. It doesn't have the heft of the big staff. But that, of course, is part of the safety value. But it's not too bad, and it certainly will do as an introductory weapon. So I've cut this one to perfect length, which means that it should be tall enough that you can reach up as far as you can and have enough on top there for both your hands. So for me, that works out at almost exactly 8 feet. And it's a little bit more flexy than the heavy one, so if I brace it again, you can see that. So that's going to absorb a lot of the force as you hit people with it. And we're just going to do something about the ends to make it a little bit friendlier and thrusting. Now, Swetnam says you should get a flax ball the size of a tennis ball and put that on the end of your staff. So we're going to do something equivalent to that. What I'm going to use is a squishy rubber ball. So this isn't hollow, this is one of these solid rubber all the way through ones. You often see these, they come yellow with smiley faces on them. This is a globe, and I got this down at the Chinese $2 shop. So it's just a little bit firmer than the yellow smiley faces one. So I got four of these, which I'm going to put one on each end of two staves. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut out a circle of that diameter with my hobby knife about halfway through the ball. So there we are. I've cut around Antarctica and drilled down into the core of the earth, and so now this slots quite neatly over the end of my staff there. So I'm going to do that for three more of them. So I've got one for each end. So now I've got my little rubber end, so you can see they're full of sort of rubber foam on the inside there. I'm now going to glue them on the end of my staff using contact adhesive, particularly stuff that is made for fixing shoes. This is really good, especially if you're working with anything that is foam-like. It's good, strong contact stuff. So this takes a little while to dry, so I'll go off and do that and come back when it's done. So now I've just glued one of those on each end of two quarterstaves, and just for both appearance sake and to protect the rubber from degradation, I'm going to cover those up. So I've just got some sort of white canvasy calico like material there that I've stolen off the missus, and I'm going to cut some squares of that out just enough to cover each end of the staff. So I've cut out little squares of material like that, wrap them around there, and just holding them on with rubber bands for now. And I'm going to wrap this up with some medical strapping tape, which I have in white rather than skin colour, and that will hold those on nice and securely. And then we're going to have two boutable quarterstaffs, which I'm going to take to training and give to the class, most of whom have never ever done quarterstaff before. This is their first course in it. And allow them to hit each other with them. So let's see how that goes.
Well, I thought that went very well, don't you?